Hi, I'm Matthew Collings, and this is the first programme in a series about Renaissance painting. We've forgotten how to value the Renaissance. You can learn how radical it was by looking at it in great detail. Seeing how the micro relates to the macro. And by thinking about it in a new way. We see Renaissance art today through its place in history, where it's what happened before modern art, and now it's part of the heritage industry. But when it was done, it was modern art. It was painters trying out new things in a moment when society was rocked by new ideas about reality. Renaissance art is artists rethinking reality. We're all familiar with these effects. The feeling of awe at the beauty of the Renaissance. I'm going to show how those effects were created and explain why they still have power over us after so many centuries. I've chosen three great works, one per programme, to sum up the range of mood that Renaissance art has. The invention of original symbols in Hieronymus Bosch's The Garden of Earthly Delights. Symbols that unhinge everything you thought you knew. The creation of space in Piero della Francesca's Baptism. Space that has a feeling of dramatic emotion, even though no one's actually emoting. And in the picture I'm going to look at in this programme, The Madonna of the Meadow by Raphael, the treatment of colour so it creates light. So the painting seems like an exquisite box of light glowing from within. I'm going to explain exactly how it works. But just as it's a picture of three figures, this story is also about three important artists. Raphael, Leonardo da Vinci, and Michelangelo. This is the triumvirate of greats, the kings of the Renaissance, whose fights to outdo each other in coming up with new effects caused a massive shift in the history of art. It could do something new now, and it would be hundreds of years before it got tired of it. An overwhelming sense of the real. And at the heart of it is this picture. Not just humans that are signs for ideas, which is what art before the Renaissance did, but humans that have real, fragile, human fleshiness. Join me on a trip to the other side of an illusion. What we're really seeing when we think we're seeing natural reality. Seeing something like the reality of a photo, or a scene from a film, or the reality of a thing actually happening in front of us. So we could step in that space and kiss those babies and give that mummy a hug.
Carry on, love is coming, love is coming to us all.
Raphael painted the Madonna of the Meadow when he was only 22. He drew this self-portrait when he was only a teenager. He must be some kind of genius, you're probably thinking. A genius is a magic being who can perform miracles. There is no such thing. Even at this young age, Raphael was working in an established visual tradition, which began around 1400, 80 years before his birth, in the region of Tuscany in central Italy. It was the tradition we call the Renaissance. It includes observed reality. Raphael's hair probably did fall like that. His mouth probably had that shape. But when he contrasts that schematic big hat with the complicated forms of the face, to show that the face is complicated, when he carefully delineates only certain features, he's idealizing reality. So what you're seeing here is as much unreal as it is real. That real-unreal tension is the place to start to understand a picture of holy beings manifested on Earth. The feeling that you could put your hand through the sheer plane of the surface of the painting and touch them is caused by a whole series of effects that Raphael has set up in this painting.
What it has to offer in terms of sheer beauty is an utter mystery of light. You are getting an amazing glow from what are very intense colours here. And that glow is elaborated by further glows, little circular repeats. So her hair binds her head in that circular shape.
Then the gold curve of that hem of her neckline is also circular. And the little children's heads are bound by their gold halos. And there are the gold curving lines on her sleeves.
So all these glowing repeats are continued through to the circular, beautiful, thin golden thread at the edge of the drapery. You are alerted to a theme of glowing.
It's a painting that's all about light. It tells you that light is colour. Raphael paints himself at 22. His life story is a fabulous dream of artistic extremes. Before he was 30, he was the most successful artist there'd ever been. He died young, he had many women. But he found time to surpass his rivals by creating restless, changeable harmonies of different colour vibrations. Which is fundamentally what the Madonna of the Meadow is. And you can see even more fundamentally what it is when it comes out of its frame. This is the research lab of the Kunsthistorisches Museum in Vienna, which owns the painting. It's now getting a check over. It's a rare chance to see a great work of art with its hallowed aura stripped away. If I bounce it back and forth between the museum wall, where it's reverent, and the museum research lab, where it's just a bit of wood with paint on, I can convey a sense of the picture's different registers. Seamless reality, heightened emotion, and inner mechanics, the hard work that Raphael is making colour do.
In relation to the other colours, the colour of the meadow is the least bright, but it is incredibly saturated. Those green-brown tones are activating every single thing in the picture.
He makes that greenish-brownish colour greener when it's next to the red, in order to make the red vibrate. And it's yellower here to make the blue vibrate. Realism